Yeah. Hey, Katie. Well, Aurora Police tells us 21 applicants applied to be the city's top cop. Now, we have just learned today that of those 21, 7 applicants were women or people of color. And then it came down to these two finalists, Scott Ebner and David Franklin. And that's where the public pushback began.
We as a community are outraged because we were left out, not just this one time, every time.
And this is causing quite a stir in the Aurora community. Our cameras were rolling at last week's press conference where several former members of Aurora's Police Oversight Task Force gathered to speak about feeling silenced in the process of finding a new chief, sharing they didn't have a seat at the table. Now, in new developments today, Aurora announcing the search will now continue. And we asked what that process may look like. Aurora said they're still not sure yet, and the city manager is assessing the next steps. But everyone wants the right person for the job. Now, today we check back in with Pastor Thomas Mays, who you just heard from, who says it's not a step, but a turn in the right direction.
I want them to get it right. Take their time. Don't rush the process. Slow down, take their time, and listen to the community and hear what they're saying. See what they're feeling. And be willing to take the hard questions and play hardball and not just find people that'll play softball with them.
Now, we have also learned today that David Franklin, chief of staff for the Albuquerque Police Department, withdrew his application after last week's selection process. And we are hearing from multiple sources that Scott Ebner, retired lieutenant colonel and deputy superintendent for administration for New Jersey State Police, is not getting support from Aurora City Council. Now, I know Aurora's new chief must have a majority council vote to be sworn in. So the city manager, who's tasked with hiring the new chief, stated in part, "We all, city management, city council, and the community, want the best person for the job who will address crime in Aurora and lead the police department to be racially equitable, bias-free, culturally competent, and responsive to all residents." Of course, we'll keep you posted right here on Fox 31.
Katie. I tell you,